So my session is what we call neighborhood drop-off prospecting. And it's part of a larger idea, but I'm going to give you the small sniglet of it right now. So here's what I'm hearing a lot, and when I say a lot, literally, if not every conversation, every other conversation is some version of, how do I restart? How do I go back? Right? Places are opening up. Masks are coming off. Social distancing are being rescinded. A lot of people are now kind of jumping back into the world, so you're going to see a lot more events. You're also going to see the tsunami take place as that when it happens, it's going to happen just like a waterfall. It's going to happen just like a tsunami. Everybody's going to open up in about the same 30 days in some capacity or another. So what I'm hearing a lot of is, how do I get started? What do I do? Right? I don't have any money, or I don't have enough money. Right? I don't have any time. I've laid off all my employees. I don't have this. Where do I get started? So there's a concept called micro-marketing. So I want you just to write this down. You're going to hear this in the future, micro-marketing. Micro-marketing is just that. It's a little, small marketing effort. It's not a full-page ad in your local paper, nothing like that. It's a small effort. And I also have to pick something that everybody has, right? Because when you start with micro-marketing, you start it based on something. But it's got to be something everybody has, because nothing's worse that says, well, do you want to make your, you know, you want to make your newspaper ad better? I think most people would say yes. The problem being is a lot of people say, well, I don't have a newspaper ad, right? Do you want your radio advertisement to be more effective? Sure do, but I don't have a radio ad, right? You want your television, again, you know, you want your website to be, do you want your Facebook to be, whatever. There are people out there, even in today's digital world, that are going to say some version of, I don't have that. So I had to pick something that everybody has. And if you're in business, regardless of the business, regardless of the circumstances, you have one thing in common with every other business on the face of the earth, which means you need customers. Customers, right? I don't care if you're a landscape business. I don't care if you're a psychiatrist. I don't care who you are, where you are, what you do. If you generate revenue from somebody, you have customers, right? We are all in business. I often say I'm in the money business. Right? I teach people how to make more money. So we have one commonality with everybody, which is customers, regardless of what business you're in, who you're in, where you're in, customers are consistent across the board. The thing is that most people, after they've developed a customer relationship, kind of abandon it, right? So imagine hypothetically, we're going to use for our illustration today, just a landscaper, right? A landscaper, right? XYZ Landscaping Company. So the idea of neighborhood drop-off prospecting says the first thing that I need to do is I need to identify a customer, any customer. And you can start today. That's the beautiful thing about this. It doesn't require 6 months preemptive. You don't have to build anything. You just have to implement. So we're going to start with a customer, any customer. And you get to pick whatever the customer is in your world. Again, regardless of who you are, what you are, it could just as easily be a house, it could be a place of business, it could be a client that you have that comes to you, but they live somewhere, they operate somewhere, whether you go out to them or they come to you. So I want you to first write down micro-marketing. Number two, I want you to write down who your neighbors, just write down who your neighbors are. And when I say who are your neighbors, imagine you have your customer, which we've identified the C, in this little circle. Now, this particular customer, and we'll just make it anywhere street, you know, Elm Street, USA, they're generally going to have some commonalities, right? They're generally going to have somebody who's north of them. They're probably going to have somebody who's east of them, south of them, and likely west of them as well, right? There's a good chance. Now, I know I'm going to get an email or something, but, you know, I live on a 9,000, you know, acre ranch, and I don't have my, don't be stupid. The idea is that almost everybody has somebody. So in a normal suburb, could be an apartment, whatever, there's generally people that are going to be around you. Could be floors up above or below. It could be left or right. Could be across the hall. If it's in a normal suburban neighborhood, you're probably going to have a neighbor across the street, most likely going to have one either side, probably even going to have one behind you. That's what your neighbors are. So the idea of neighbor drop-off prospecting is, since we all have customers, we've all got that commonality of a person, and likely that person will have a place where we're doing business at in most cases, they probably have people surround them. And these people may, write this down, may have the same problems, right? the word problem. We are problem solvers looking for problems to solve.